If a matrix A, n by n, has n linearly independent eigenvectors, this is like the nice matrices that are symmetric, then we can do a very nice matrix multiplication on A to transform it into a diagonal matrix. Diagonal matrices are very easy to compute with. Usually they mean that when you have a system of equations of some type, the system, the equations decouple, you can solve each one individually, very easy to work with. So this is a very important topic in matrix algebra, and let me try to explain it to you first for the simple case of a 2x2 matrix, and then generalize it to an n by n matrix. So let's start with a 2x2 matrix. We have, let's say we have two eigenvalues and two linearly independent eigenvectors. So we have lambda 1, and then the eigenvector is x1. And let me write it explicitly. So I'm going to use a notation where x1 is going to look like the first column of some matrix. So the first component of x1 I'll write as x11. And then the second component I'll write as the second row, first column, so x21, okay? So we'll use this notation. So this is the eigenvector, lambda 1 is the eigenvalue. And then there's a second eigenvalue, lambda 2, associated with a second eigenvector. And this eigenvector I'm going to write as the second column of a matrix. So the first component will be row 1, column 2, and then x row 2, column 2. Okay, so we'll denote the eigenvector like this. So two eigenvalues and two eigenvectors. And this is a 2x2 matrix, which I'm going to call capital A. Okay? So what do we have? We know that A, x1 equals lambda, right? We know the eigenvalue problem, A, x1 equals lambda 1, x1. We know that A, x2 equals lambda 2, x2. But we can write this rather than as a matrix times a vector, we can write this as a matrix times a matrix. So I want to write this as A times the matrix with x1 in the first column, so x11, x21, with x2 in the second column, x12, x22, right? And then what is this equal to? Well, we can just do the first column first and the second column second. So if we do the first column first, A times the first column is equal to lambda times the first column. So this is lambda here is lambda 1. So this is lambda 1, x11, lambda 1, x21. Then A times the second column is equal to lambda 2 times the second column. So this is lambda 2, x12, times lambda 2, x22. Okay? So all I'm doing now is combining the two eigenvalue problems into one single matrix. This matrix here can be decomposed into the product of two matrices. This one is x11, x12, x21, x22. And then to get lambda 1 multiplying the first column of this matrix, we have a lambda 1 in this diagonal. To get lambda 2 multiplying the second column of this matrix, we have a lambda 2 in the diagonal and 0, 0, right? So the first column is lambda 1, x11 plus 0. The second element in the first column is lambda 1, x21 plus 0. So we get multiplying lambda 1 times the first column, lambda 2 times the second column. Okay. So what is this one? Then we have A times this matrix consisting of the eigenvectors in the columns. So I'm going to call that S, is equal to that matrix with the eigenvectors in the column, S, times a diagonal matrix, lambda. So lambda is the diagonal matrix with the eigenvalues along the diagonal. So we have AS equals S lambda. A was our 2x2 matrix, right? I didn't even tell you what that matrix was because it's not important. It's probably a symmetric matrix because both eigenvalues are real, but doesn't necessarily have to be. A times S. S is this matrix we formed where the first column is the first eigenvector, the second column is the second eigenvector, is equal to the matrix S again times a diagonal matrix where the diagonal matrix has the eigenvalues along the diagonal. The first element corresponds to the first column of S. The second eigenvalue corresponds to the second column of S. So this was true for the 2x2 case. This is also true for the n by n case. Okay? So this equation is true for an n by n matrix that has n linearly independent eigenvectors. And if the eigenvectors are linearly independent, this S is diagonalizable, so we can multiply on the, I mean, this S is invertible, sorry. If the columns of S are linearly independent, S is an invertible matrix, we can multiply on the right by S inverse, and we get A is equal to S lambda times S inverse. Or we can multiply on the left by N S inverse, and we get the diagonal matrix is equal to S inverse A times S. Okay? Two very important relationships. So this in this second relationship, lambda equals S inverse AS, we say that we have diagonalized the matrix A by multiplying by the eigenvectors matrix on the right and this inverse on the left. We found a diagonal matrix. The other first expression is just a factorization of the matrix A. We factored A into the product of three matrices, where the middle matrix is a diagonal matrix. Both of these results are important. So you might ask, how do you remember these results? It actually is not that hard to remember it, because you have to remember that A has to be multiplied on the right by the eigenvectors. The eigenvectors are in the matrix S, so you know you have an S and an S inverse. The only thing that's difficult to remember is the order. You know, you might forget and might write something else, some different order. But if you remember that A should be multiplied on the right by S, then if you multiply this first expression on the right by S, then you get an AS equals S lambda. That's the right one. And here, A is multiplied on the right by S, so it has to be in this expression. Okay, so what have we done? I've shown you that if you can find what's called a complete set of eigenvectors for a matrix, so an n by n matrix with n linearly independent eigenvectors, then you can diagonalize that matrix. You can get a diagonal matrix lambda with eigenvalues along the diagonal by writing S inverse AS, where S is this matrix of eigenvectors. Or on the other hand, you can do a factorization of A as S lambda times S inverse. We'll make use of this in later videos. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.